Hello dear learners, in today's video we are going to see about the classification of industries under the chapter industries. Let's get started. In the previous video we saw about the classification of the industries on the basis of ownership. So in today's video we are going to see about the industries, how it is classified on the basis of the raw material. First one, the agro-based industries. It is from the name itself we can obtain the answer. Yes, agro-based. So something which is based on the agricultural sector. So here, for example, the cotton textile industry, it depends upon the cotton. So the raw material is cotton. So the jute industry, the vegetable oil industry, the food processing industry, all these are the agro-based industries. So any industry which is depending for the raw material from the agricultural sector, it is termed as the agro-based industries. Next, we'll move on to the mineral-based industry. These industries, they obtain their raw materials from minerals, which are then, it will be processed and then turned into the finished products. So here it is the iron and steel industry. They depend upon the iron ore, locomotive industry, automobile industry, cement industry and aluminium industry. So everything, it needs that mineral. The next one is the forest-based industry. They obtain their raw materials from the forest, that is the natural vegetation, like the shrubs, herbs, grasses, trees. Okay, so here the raw material, it will be in the form of wood or the wood pulp. So the industries which is associated with this forest are the wood pulp and paper, cardboard, rayons, pharmaceuticals, furniture and fittings, timber and rubber. The next is the marine based industry. So here it will be based upon the raw material which is obtained from the sea and oceans. So for example, the seafood processing industries, manufacturers of the cod liver oil. Okay, well, these are the examples. Next one is the pastoral based industry. That is, they obtain their raw material from the animals. The raw material, it will be that is the wool, hide, meat and milk. Woolen textile industry, the dairy industry and the leather industry. Okay, all these are the pastoral based industry. On the basis of size, the industries are classified on the basis of the size. It is classified into cottage industries, small scale industries and large scale industries. The cottage industry. So this industry, it is also known as the household industries or the village industries. So here the people, they will be they will work. It will be in a small area in their house, okay, and they use simple tools to make things. Out of that they can get some profit. So this is, they work from home, so they don't use any machines. Some examples, if you see, they will be making the jewelry. And then the toy making, weaving, the pottery, shoemaking, all these are the household industries or the cottage industry. They will be selling their products in their local market itself. So for local consumption, they will be using the local raw materials and they will be making the things. Cottage industry, they are more supported by the exports. Okay, the foreigners, they love to buy the handicraft things that is made through the people, those who are involved in the cottage industry. So these products are exported. So it is encouraged in India. So in that case, it will be helping the village-based artisans to earn a living by reflecting the tradition and skills in the products which they are making. So this is, for example, the weaving and the pottery. Next one is the small scale industries. The manufacturing unit is set up with a limited capital. Here they will they cannot do it on their own, so they will be getting the workers, they hire the skilled laborers. When it is compared, it is bigger than the cottage industry. So here the amount of capital and the technology which is implied, it is comparatively, it is less than the large scale industry, and they generate a great deal of employment. They mainly produce the domestic markets and they also export to global markets. Then they use the small scale industries, they use the machines that run on power, they obtain the raw materials from outside areas, Here the production is more when it is compared with that of the cottage industry. So here they sell their products in the markets through traders who will be taking the products from the supply locals to the demand locals. So it functions under the private sector. And this small scale industry units are engaged in silk weaving. They'll be producing the garments. Here the food and leather items also included. They also manufacture chemicals, manufacture furnitures and fittings and automobile components. Now coming to the large scale industry, they use a large amount of capital. Huge machines will be used here. And here they will be using the advanced technology for manufacturing goods. So to run the machines, these industries, they need huge amount of power supply and they also need enormous number of workers. And they obtain the raw material even from the distant regions. They even import, okay, the raw materials. The production, it will be voluminous, it will be more, it will be on a mass scale. And they sell the goods, they export it usually, okay, to distant markets. Some of the large scale industries are the iron and steel industry, petrochemicals, textile industry, aircraft, railway coach, cement industry. Yes, children, in this video, we saw about the classification of industries. In the next video, we will be seeing in detail about the factors affecting location of industries. Thank you, children.